How did birds originate from dinosaurs? Welcome to the natural history of dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. Ever since the discovery in 1861 of a mysterious fossilized feather in the late Jurassic Solahofen limestone in Germany, given the name Archaeopteryx, paleontologists have puzzled over the owner of this feather. Since the initial discovery in 1861, 11 additional specimens have been found, demonstrating the skeletal anatomy of Archaeopteryx, the ancient feather or wing. There are 11 specimens of Archaeopteryx preserving the skeleton, and impressions of the wings of this creature. The most recent skeleton was described in July of 2014. Although missing a head, the specimen demonstrates the feather impressions that led a century of paleontologists to conclude that Archaeopteryx was the first bird originating in the Jurassic. But what makes Archaeopteryx a bird rather than a feathered dinosaur? Like the winged Umaniraptor and theropods that we've been studying. All right, so let's take a look in detail at the skeleton of Archaeopteryx. This is the Berlin specimen of Archaeopteryx, undoubtedly the most famous fossil ever discovered. We can see that it lacks many of the features of the modern bird skeleton, but the wings, which are preserved as feather impressions, are unmistakably bird-like. If we reconstruct the skeleton of Archaeopteryx, we can see that it contains a mosaic of both bird and dinosaur features. An amazing transitional fossil between the Umaniraptor and dinosaurs and aves, the birds. All right, so let's look at the primitive features of Archaeopteryx. We can think of these traits as dinosaur traits. First, it has teeth. Small teeth in sockets, similar to theropod dinosaurs, but are unserrated. Two, it has a small sternum, which lacks a keel. This is similar to what we saw in Velociraptor. Three, a pubis bone and ilium and ischium that are not fused into a synsacrum. Four, that long bony tail. Birds lack bony tails. Five, the metatarsals in the foot are not fused into a tarsa metatarsus bone like they are in birds. Six, Archaeopteryx has three digits in the hand rather than a fused carpal metacarpus bone. Now looking at these traits, it appears that Archaeopteryx is a dinosaur. All right, let's now look at the derived features of Archaeopteryx. We can think of these as the bird traits. First, this creature has a large brain with a larger orbit for the eye, much like we saw in chickens. Two, the skull is very nimble and exhibits streptostyle with a kinetic skull with a movable quadrate. A similar style of skull is found in many birds. Number three, the coracoid bone has a hook-like notch for the supracoidocoideus tendon, which means that it could flap its wings. Four, we can't forget those stage five feathers that almost look modern. And five, the helix or big toe is reflected backward, the ansodactyl trait found in birds. So which is it? What makes Archaeopteryx the oldest true bird? Now scientists don't all agree, but the small notch for the supracoidocoideus tendon is one trait that makes Archaeopteryx a bird and not a dinosaur. This trait means that Archaeopteryx, unlike Velociraptor for example, could flap its wings. Now this trait alone defines then the transition from dinosaur to bird. All right, so let's look at how dinosaurs acquired all these bird-like traits. So the dinosauria had an anorbital opening, three forward pointed toes, digits 2, 3, and 4 with a reduced digit 1. They had clawed toes and a metatarsal joint. The theropoda group of dinosaurs, Saurischian dinosaurs, had hollow bones, a three-fingered hand with a diagnostic metacarpals. The Tenura have a furcula, wishbone, and a stiffened tail. The Saurischians had a shortened ischium and large orbits. The Maniraptorans had three grasping fingers with that semilunate carpal bone, kind of similar to what you see in birds. Short pubis, they have elongated digit number 2. The Eumeniraptorans have reduced their fibula, and they have much longer arms. And then we come to the Aves. The Aves lose the serrations in their teeth, and they gain this groove for the supracoidocoideous tendon on the coracoid that's used for powered flight, found in Archaeopteryx, but not any other primitive dinosaur. Now, it's really important to note that Archaeopteryx does not have a pygiostyle. It doesn't have a carpal metacarpus. It doesn't have that big keeled sternum. It still has teeth, so it's not doesn't have a toothless beak like most birds. It doesn't have a metatarsal bone in the foot, and the synsacrum. It doesn't have a synsacrum like you see in modern birds. So all of these things make Archaeopteryx still very primitive when we compare it to modern birds. All right, so what about Microraptor? Why is Microraptor, this is a feathered Eumeniraptoran dinosaur, why is it not considered a bird? It sure does look like a bird with those feather impressions. Well, Microraptor lacks the key bird trait of having a tendon for the supracoidocoideous muscle running from the humerus to the sternum through that hook in the coracoid. As such, Microraptor could not raise its arms much higher than this diagram. Microraptor was a glider and likely didn't flap its wings, but Archaeopteryx could flap its wings. And this is the sole difference between a dinosaur and a bird. When we start looking at the transition between dinosaur and bird, what is most remarkable to me is that the differences between dinosaurs and birds are minor differences, and that while looking at the skeleton of a giant sauropod dinosaur, big giant dinosaur, comparing that to a chicken, it makes the whole idea seem sort of ridiculous. However, when we look at the numerous chains of fossils between dinosaurs marching up to birds, it really demonstrates this stepwise acquisition of traits, such that we must divide these two major big groups between dinosaurs and birds right on that line between Microraptor and Archaeopteryx as to where to draw the line between bird and dinosaur. All right, so you should now be able to assemble the anatomical characters that link dinosaurs to birds and explain each of the steps in the origin of the typical bird skeleton using Archaeopteryx as an example, and evaluate the placement of that dinosaur-bird dichotomy on the evolutionary tree and justify this position with an explanation.